This is Highway 56 north of Gainesboro, and this is North Fork Road. It runs off of 56 about 4 miles outside Whitleyville. This is a rather unassuming Tennessee crossroad, and unless you live on North Fork, there is very little reason for you to take the drive down to the end of it. But if you do, there are two surprises. Number one, the studios of Freestone Pottery, and number two, the delightful owners, Sally and Tom Freestone. Tom is from England, Sally from New England. They have been Mr. and Mrs. since 1985 and have been in Jackson County for 2 years. They really wanted to buy something other than this studio, but it just didn't quite work out that way.
Basically, we were looking for a gristmill. We went through all the different magazines and the Spoon magazine, which I'm a great member, and there was nothing suitable at the time. And then in 86, I was asked to go back to England to be presented by Princess Anne with the Winston Churchill medallion, which was a very proud moment for me.
What is the award for?
It's something that Sir Winston Churchill, he died January 24th, 1965, and before his death he had consulted with dignitaries that his wish would be to have a foundation or a trust built made in the United Kingdom and in the USA to establish a trust so that all walks of life can travel all four corners of the earth. When we returned, we were looking through, or Sally was looking through one of the ceramics monthlies and said, oh, that place down in Tennessee is still advertising. And we flew down and looked at it on the Saturday and Sunday, and Monday we bought it.
Sally, you are from the Northeast, and Tom, you're from England, and now you are in the middle of Jackson County, Tennessee, 10 miles out of Gainesboro, and Lord knows how many miles off the main road. What brought you to this place?
Well, now you've just come here, can you see anything better? What a beautiful place. Look at all the hills. You've got the four seasons here. Admittedly, the winter's very short. At least it has been since we've been here 2 years.
Was it a major adjustment to you to come here?
No, we adapted so well, it's unbelievable.
It's amazing how quickly we adapted. I think the one thing we really miss are all the old friends back in the Northeast. But we get them down here. They come down and visit us here.
And they
envy us.
Oh, they envy you?
Yes.
I think we're the thin edge of a wedge.
I think so, too.
I think Jackson County and other counties in Tennessee are going to find a lot of people getting out of the rat race and coming into these parts.
Tom, have you had any regrets of coming here and longing maybe if you go back home to England?
It's a big word, no.
None at all?
None at all. I'm not even homesick. I haven't been from the time we've set foot in Tennessee.
That's true.
I've never met such good, genuine people in my life.
Yeah.
I mean, not just one or two. I mean, everywhere we go, they're marvelous. I've heard of Southern hospitality, but this is great.
Sally, you are the potter.
Yes, I make the pottery. I throw the pots. That's a term that potters use, meaning making the pots on a potter's wheel.
A lot of people might say you mold them.
Molding is a dirty word to potters. It means you use molds. Now, ceramics is the big word, meaning slip pouring mainly. And slip pouring is something that potters do if they make their own molds. But basically, when you're talking about pottery, you mean handmade pottery. And molding is part of that if you make your own molds.
What is Freestone Pottery?
Well, Freestone is our name. And people can't quite understand that. They say they think it's a kind of pottery, which in a way it really is. Freestone is a kind of pottery. It's a very unique kind of pottery. We think we are the only people who do what we do. We put biblical phrases on our pottery. The Freestone, signed clearly on the bottom of every piece, is significant because we feel each piece is a little part of us, an advertisement for what we're trying to do.
Are you trying to promote a message through your pottery?
Yeah, we really are. It's not our message. It's pretty old. It's been around for thousands of years. We're just trying to allow people who wish to have the Word of God in their homes a beautiful and very upfront way of saying, hey, I am God's child, by the things they use in their cooking and in their lives. When you hand somebody a mug to drink out of, even if he doesn't feel particularly close to God, that says, let everything that breathes praise the Lord, he can't help or she be affected by drinking out of that mug. And that's good.